We're here in Madison, Wisconsin. Tormach is located just up the road. And over the years, I've always was fascinated by the idea of, you know, these low-cost, highly capable CNC machines. We're trying to incorporate more of the real-world experience into our program, which a lot of our students wanted to do a project around CNC machine tending. A lot of companies still do a lot of machining and trying to automate and be more efficient. So part of that is trying to load parts automatically and unload parts automatically and have a more complete process in place. So that brought us to Tormach to work with them, you know, since they had equipment available that fit our scale that we can build and interface with as well as our budget. And work with them on an idea to combine robotics and machine tending and CNC programming. We were fortunate with this particular project. We have a student who is also finishing up the machine tooling techniques program. So he really jumped in and took control of the CNC programming, CAD/CAM side of things, where his partner focused more on the integration of the robot and the PLC programming.
So the concept of the project was to automate any type of machining operation that might be found in manufacturing. And Peter and your group was willing to supply us with a small vertical machining center to do this project with.
So we're making a dice, and I think the kind of behind that was it was just more simple. So we're trying to show off more of the process and not so much make a really intricate part and everything, you know.
Not to have a lot of machining time, but to show how much automation is needed to produce the part, and not so much of the machining part of it. Yeah,
we used, with the Fanuc robot we got, there's a vision system built in into the controller for the robot, so we used the vision system to actually pick parts off of the conveyor. Like, we use three pneumatic cylinders, one that just controls clamping of the vise and actually has the vise jaws and everything. Then we have another one that has a 90-degree rotational pneumatic cylinder mounted on the end of it, and that allows it to come into the vise because it has a suction cup on the end to actually grab the part. So then it can come into the vise, pull it back out, and then it does a 90-degree turn so it can load the part back in a new position so it can work on the next phase of the dice. We're using a PLC to control the vise, and then it also controls the takes communications from the robot so we know what cycle the robot's in and where it's at in the cycle, and then also from the Tormach to know what the Tormach's doing, if it's running or not. So that was a little bit of a challenge to get all the communications set up between the PLC, the robot, and the Tormach. So.
You know, our students get so much out of interfacing with different pieces of equipment. So because in industry, they're going to run into all kinds of machines. And here was something that was new. You know, they've never had a machine that had a USB interface, talk to a PLC. So just integrating that was a great experience.
I didn't have any experience with CNC equipment before I came to MATC here, but I have taken classes in the machine tool program, so I have G-code experience and CAM experience. So it was helpful to have that background to generate the programs and understand, have a concept of what the equipment was capable of doing. I found PathPilot very, very simple to use and very straightforward. I didn't have my first experience with it, and I found it very easy to navigate, and found it very helpful in accomplishing what we were trying to do. No, I thought the system seems to be pretty robust for its compact size. It worked well and didn't see any issues or problems. It was accuracy and repeatability were excellent. Ran really well for us.
If you look across the hall where we have the production level CNC equipment, those are humongous machines. They weigh thousands of pounds. They cost hundreds of thousands of dollars. And so a lot of students are intimidated by that type of equipment. So when they see the smaller equipment that doesn't look quite as scary, has a simpler user interface on it, we found that the students jumped right on it and were like, yeah, I want to try this. I want to learn this. The 440s, it's such a nice footprint. I'd love to have one in my basement to tool around with. It's really perfect size, perfect capabilities for our needs. Yeah, I look forward to utilizing it more, and you know, either on a manufacturing level for our students to make parts on, or to integrate again and even take it a little bit further and automate the machine tending and machining process even further.
Or suddenly it ends up in your basement.
Yep, yeah, you know, nobody's going to miss it over the summer, right?
After graduation, I'm going full-time at the company that I worked at over the summer for an internship, so I'm going to be working for a system integrator. Doing kind of similar stuff to this, probably not so much the machine tending, but I'll be building machines and doing a lot with the FANUC robots and everything in the future.
Now that I've been exposed to both the CNC world and the automation world, I think I'm going to look for some type of position with a machine tool vendor, maybe as a field service guy out doing automation for different manufacturing companies.
Really just, you know, I want to thank again Tormach for their partnership and support. You know, we kind of approached them, and within 4 weeks we had one of the first production machines available for us to work with. And you know, without their local support and you know, dedication, we would have been able to do this and showcase Tormach and our program to the local industry. And it's a great partnership, and we look forward to continuing that. And as far as our program, our students get so much out of interfacing with different pieces of equipment. So because in industry, they're going to run into all kinds of machines. And here was something that was new. You know, they've never had a machine that had a USB interface, talk to a PLC. So just integrating that was a great experience.